Session 20 of Industrial Relations and Labour Legislation of 6th Semester BBA of Mangalore University. In this session, we shall study about bipartite bodies, and under bipartite bodies, we shall study Works Committee and Joint Management Council. Bipartite bodies constitute a system of industrial relations where social and labor issues are discussed between trade union and management, usually at the enterprise level. The bipartite consultative machinery comprises two constituents, the works committees and the joint management councils. These are purely consultative and not negotiating bodies. This consultative joint machinery with equal representation of the employers and the workers has been set up exclusively for dealing with disputes affecting the plant or industry. So let us see what is works committees. These committees have been regarded as the most effective social institution of industrial democracy and as a statutory body established within the industrial units with representatives of management and workers for preventing and settling industrial disputes at the unit level. The works committee can be formed by an enterprise employing 100 or more workers. Committees try to promote industrial goodwill and harmonious relations through better understanding of employees by management and management by workers. The objectives of works committees is to remove the cause of friction in the day-to-day work situation by providing an effective grievance-resolving machinery. To promote measures securing good relationship. To serve as a useful adjunct in establishing continuous bargaining relationship. To strengthen the spirit of settlement, that is voluntary settlement, rendering recourse to conciliation, arbitration, adjudication for these achieved by commenting upon matters of concern or endeavor to compose any material difference of opinion in respect of such matters. The second bipartite body is Joint Management Council. These committees give labor a greater sense of participation and infuse a spirit of cooperation between the two parties without encroaching upon each other's sphere of influence, rights and prerogatives. They establish a channel of close mutual interaction between labor and management. Keeping tension at a low level generates a cooperative atmosphere for negotiation and settlement. These committees also aim at making the will of the employees effective in the management, ensures the operation of the private-owned concern in conformity with national interests and provide for a popular agency for supervising the management of nationalized undertakings. References.